Manchester City came from behind to win a record equaling 13th Premier League match in a row with victory over Stoke West Ham at Etihad Stadium. Angel Ogbonna said on the stroke of half-time put the lowly Merseyside, but Nicolas Otamendi responded with a predatory finish shortly after the break. David Silva got it for City, acrobatic and converting a Kevin De Bruyne pass with 7 minutes left. Victory Mayan, Pep Guardiola see the re-established 8 point lead over Manchester United, but they play at Old Trafford next Sunday, 16:30 GMT. They also acquired the longest winning run within a top flight season, matching Sunderland and Preston, 1891-92, Arsenal, 2001-02, and Chelsea, 2016-17. West Ham, Stoke, have set a club record for the fewest points after 15 Premier League matches, they have just 10. The Londoners had their chances, as well as Ogbonna's goal, Michail Antonio almost ponced when Ederson spilled the goal, and Manuel Lanzini forced the goal Kepa to save at his near post. But it always looked as though this pressure goal Delan, shortly after De Bruyne's free kick was palmed away, Gabriel Jesus skipped through and slid the ball to Otamendi, who scored. Leroy Sané, Raheem Sterling, De Bruyne and Jesus had further chances before Silva got it for the home side, but there was still time for the Hammers to go close, with Diafra Sakho shooting just wide after Marco Arnautovic pulled the ball back. City have it late to win, a game point Silva's streak melted the fourth game in a row City have gone thanks to a goal scored in or after the 83rd minute. Sterling has scored the past 3, having also hit an injury time winner at Bournemouth in August. A home victory always looked the likeliest result, with City extending their unbeaten run in all competitions to 28 matches. They were made to fight for the points. Stoke, and Silva's late winner was one of 18 shots they had in the second half. While City have been in full flow for much of the season, they have also shown their resilience, taking a leave high 10 points from los 5 seasons. Prior to their late winners against Huddersfield last month and now West Ham, City had gone only one of their past 30 games in which they had been behind at half-time. That combination of Silk and Steel has taken them 8 points clear at the top, and it will take something special to stop them. Positives in the field for Moyes. Despite the defeat, there was plenty for Hammers boss David Moyes to take heart from as he see the cap the league leaders at by for almost an hour. The first half was particularly encouraging and, though a deflected streak from Silva extended Adrian, West Ham had better chances through Antonio and Lanzini. They look defensively solid and confident in their game plan, and Moyes' only disappointment will be they could not keep it up. Jesus' half-time introduction made a difference, but Sané, De Bruyne and Silva, who had not been at their best in the first half, also began to influence things. City had 6 shots to the Hammers 4 prior to that, but Adrian was forced into a string of saves as the hosts bombarded his goal in search of a winner. Adrian, who came in as Hoyart was unable to face his parent club, was a stand-up performer but the amazing opportunities of the room despite the absence of striker Sandy Carroll and Javier Hernández. And the agony signature of this defeat was summed by the reaction of former City defender Pablo Zabaleta when Silva shot hit the back of the net. Well served to equalize apostrophe point David Moyes a quinto BBC Radio 5 Live, y a Beto Said was a real goal de Ford. We defended much better today. Web work David on it. We had one day where we could prepare. When I did our goalkeeper to play well, punto, I got buttons to most things. Punto, it took most of it was outside the box. I have to say, what did I really got the job? What a chance we have to make it 2-2 late on. My feeling was it took well served it to equalize. You had results in different ways and it looked as though when it have got one today. For long parts of the game we were in with a chance. Pep Guardiola's packing to match of the day, we started really well but we lost our patience. We didn't have any rhythm because Adrian was taking 30 seconds every time. It was similar to the last few games, in the second half it took the world score. They played 10 players inside the box, it was almost impossible. It's a big victory. It showed what we are. We had two strikers in the second half and that helped. It was a big lesson for me. We created more with two. We spoke a lot about defending set pieces but they are tired. Yeah. It will happen again next week against United, so we have to try and concede fewer set pieces. Punto record equaling success and record breaking disappointment, the rest of the stats. City have acquired the longest winning run within a top flight season. Punto City solo 43 points from 15 games is a joint top flight record, level with Tottenham in 1960-61, converted to 3 points for a win. West Ham's total of 10 points from 15 games is the lowest in the Premier League and lowest in the top flight since 1976-77, mine, converted to 3 for a win. Since his debut for City in September 2015, De Bruyne has provided 35 assists in the league, more than any other in the five European leagues. Jesus has been directly involved in 21 goals in his 24 Premier League appearances so far, 15 goals, 6 assists. Ogbonna scored his first goal in the five European leagues, in his 144th appearance. Man of the match, Adrian. What's next? West Ham returned to London Stadium to face Chelsea on Saturday, 12:30 GMT, in the first of two successive home games, with Arsenal to come afterwards. Manchester City travel to Ukraine to take on Shakhtar Donetsk in the Champions League on Wednesday, 19:45 GMT, and return to League Action against Manchester United at Old Trafford on Sunday, 16:30.